In other news, the U.S. has imposed a year-long ban on temporary work visas for Filipinos beginning late last week on January 19th. The U.S. Department of Homeland Security removed the Philippines from the list of countries eligible for the temporary visas. It cited overstaying and human trafficking concerns. The H-2A and H-2B visas allow employers to hire foreign workers to temporarily stay in the United States and perform services on a one-time, seasonal, or intermittent basis. MalacaÃ says it respects Washington's decisions, but adds Manila's diplomats will look into the issue.
So if that is the law in the U.S. and that there were violations, then we have to respect. If they have basis for that, we will only react if our workers are being mistreated, maltreated, are being discriminated against. But if they violated the laws of the U.S., then they have to face the music.
An expert with 26 years of practice in U.S. immigration law believes Washington's decision is only temporary and will not affect current visa holders.
Prospective nga yung disqualification or yung ban, no? Mm-hmm. Kasi yung mga H-2A and H-2B visa holders right now, of course, we are assuming na valid yan in an increment of 1 year or has been extended for additional year or so. Uh-uh. So hindi sila affected ng ban na ito. So they cannot be just simply going out and pulling out the checklist of all the current H-2A and H-2B visa holders. Otherwise, that will be a denial of due process. Kung titignan mo, yung victims na ito, compared now to the status of the Philippine government, we are now in Tier 1. So Tier 1 is full compliance of the Philippine government of the human trafficking laws of the United States. So na-meet niya yung standards, minimum and maximum standards, kaya nalipat tayo sa Tier 1.